this evening we have a very special performance as our first concert. It's a very unusual and rare opportunity to hear music that we never hear, rarely hear. And when we do, we normally hear it on the Highland Pipes. It's Pibroch, the music of the Highland Pipes, which is a theme and variation set. And these pieces can be short, 10 minutes up to 30 minutes. So we're going to have an opportunity this evening to hear a very large scale piece. And our performer is the assistant director of Scotland Worship, Simon Chadwick, who's come from Scotland. And some of us, I mean, myself for example, I work on more accessible repertoire from the 17th, from the 16th to the 18th century. But Simon is out there at the coalface working at the really unusual, speculative, difficult to access repertoire. He's trying to get as far back in time as he can to find really ancient repertoire that fits this instrument. So would you please welcome a really innovative performer, Simon Chadwick. Thank you.
Thank you everyone for coming along this evening.
This is,
like Siobhan said, this is a kind of experiment, trying to reimagine very ancient Gaelic music. And it's a kind of archaeological experiment. So it starts with the harp. This is a kind of archaeological copy of the medieval harp that's preserved in Edinburgh, the twin sister, if you like, of the famous medieval Irish harp in Trinity College in Dublin. And so searching for this, for the music that would have been heard when these instruments were new, has taken me in this direction. So, the context of this music is the ceremonial court music of the Lords of the Isles, an independent Gaelic kingdom in between Ireland and Scotland, in the Hebrides, and their capital at Finlaggan. And their cathedral at Iona. And so, I'm not going to play a series of tunes like you would hear in a sit-down concert, because I don't think the Lords of the Isles had that kind of music. I think their music would have been an embedded part of their ceremony and their court life at Finlaggan. So I'm just going to play for half an hour in a kind of evolving sequence of repetitive cycles. But for your part, you don't need to sit there fixated on what I'm doing. Feel free to chat, feel free to go up to the back and refill your glasses. Feel free to leave and go and find a more interesting thing to listen to. Because I think this is what the Lords of the Isles would have done when their harpers were playing. Okay? Feel free to come and sit on the floor. I think I should be sitting on the floor. We studied how to sit with a medieval harp in class this morning, and they didn't sit up in seats like this. But you wouldn't be able to see them. Enjoy yourself. Don't pay any attention to me. I'm just a harper. Okay. So the tune is called Cogach no Si, War or Peace. And the way it works is there is a kind of vocal, lyrical theme, which is then dissected and taken apart into geometrical patterns, like the carpet pages in the Book of Kells. And every time you turn a new page, you get a new abstract design on the same theme. And so I'm going to attempt to play a cycle, two different cycles that combine to give you 12 variations. It might not be 12, I'm not sure how many it will end up being. The first six are my reconstruction based on fragments of medieval Welsh harp tradition, and the last five, six-ish, are based on the traditional bagpipe themes that Siobhan mentioned. And if not, do go and get one.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.